I want to take some time to update you on the weather associated with Helene. We'll update you on that system and talk about the threats to Hampton Roads as well. We've had a weather alert day because there is a tornado threat. In fact, the Storm Prediction Center just issued a tornado watch for Hampton Roads and for northern North Carolina, really most of North Carolina, as you'll see in just a moment. But for the 13 News Now viewing area, northeast North Carolina and Hampton Roads, areas to the north not under that watch, but you still need to stay weather aware. And the watch will run through 6 o'clock this evening. We do have the potential for isolated severe storms this afternoon. Main threat is going to be spin-up tornadoes. There could be some possible heavy downpours as well. Now, the center of Helene is actually back here, right around the western tip of South Carolina. You'll notice this line here extending down. This is the area that we've been concerned with developing and then eventually rotating into our area. And that's why the National Weather Service and the Storm Prediction Center has issued this new watch. We don't have anything so far, but you know that potential is going to build across the region. Again, precipitation to the southwest coming in. You'll notice this includes Williamsburg, all of the peninsula, and then Southside Hampton Roads, Surrey, Isle of Wight, Southampton County, Franklin. You can see, again, Southside, Suffolk, Chesapeake, Virginia Beach, and then northeast North Carolina down through the Outer Banks. As I expand the view a little bit farther to the south, the rain's already started there out to the west of Raleigh and down to the southwest. It will continue to rotate up and through our area later today. Numerous flood warnings. It is a huge story back out over western parts of North Carolina. So much rain, they could also have some issues with mudslides out there in the high country. So we're definitely concerned with that. This line here has had a history of producing little spin-up tornadoes, so we're going to continue to watch this as it develops and moves closer to Hampton Roads later in the day. Take a look here again. There's the main area of low pressure, the center of circulation with Helene. It is going to move back to the north and eventually the northwest. It's actually continued to weaken a little bit with the latest update at 8 o'clock. The winds were down to 60 miles per hour, so we'll continue to watch that. Again, radar sweeping clear this morning, but that's going to change as we get into the afternoon. Now, as far as the flood outlook goes, there is a very good chance of flooding rain. It's already happening out there. The rain coming down heavy over North Georgia into South Carolina and the mountains of North Carolina. That heavier rain may extend up. There's a level 3 or moderate threat of flooding rains over the mountains here in western Virginia. Across the Piedmont, it's level 2 and then a level 1 threat for Hampton Roads and for northeast North Carolina. That heavy rain with the system over the mountains and then eventually pulling back towards Kentucky and Tennessee. You'll notice tomorrow a lesser threat for the heavy rains as the system pulls a little farther to the west, but still it continues back across parts of Kentucky and Indiana. Here's a look at our forecast for our area. Again, showers potentially through noon, but we're going to see the heavier cells developing through the late afternoon, mid to late afternoon, and this is when we have that threat for isolated tornadoes into the early evening. Once that moves out, things will be improving. So we do have that. Want to take a little closer look at that severe weather threat. Again, a level 2 threat for Hampton Roads. This includes those areas under the watch. That's why the Hurricane Center went ahead and issued that watch. So again, you can see for the peninsula, Southside Hampton Roads, and for northeast North Carolina, all of these areas bracing for that. Now, as far as the system goes itself, I do want to switch things up and I'll show you the forecast track for this system. With the 8 o'clock update, you can see the winds were at 60 miles per hour, the movement north at 30, but there is going to be a gradual turn to the northwest, and then the center is going to track back over portions of Kentucky and Tennessee. So a lot of rain there potentially for us here in Hampton Roads. What we're going to find across the area, temperatures today topping out in the upper 70s to low 80s, rain developing later on, and the chances for strong to severe storms with some rotating cells later this afternoon. Again, that watch for Hampton Roads and the peninsula and North Carolina until 6 o'clock tonight. After that, we're going to see improvements coming overnight, 75 the low tomorrow, back up to 86. And beyond that, we'll see the temperatures warm tomorrow, obviously, but a little cooler on Sunday. Slight chance of a shower late Sunday. Better chances for scattered wet weather Monday into Tuesday, and then really nice for the end of the following week. We'll look forward to that nicer weather. Stay weather aware through the afternoon. Continue to check back with 13 News Now. Be sure and check in with our digital platforms as well, 13 Plus. And again, we'll keep you updated throughout today's events.